Hello and welcome to Paul's Chess Game. No. Hi folks. So I've decided to record myself playing a video a game chess game. I just thought why not? So anyway, yeah, I haven't had a game of chess in ages, so I thought and so I love this. I've had this on my computer for yonks. It's a 3D chess game. I really like it actually because I love the fact, look, you can just move it around. How cool is this? Look at that. You can get all these different angles. It's a really cool little chess game actually. I really like it. It's free. I got it off online. You just download it. And like I said, I've had it on my computer for ages. I have done a couple of videos before featuring this game. Sorry, I am just trying to see what it looks like in the screen. So yeah, right. So it's on easy mode. There's different levels. I don't want to mess about too much with the settings and stuff right now because otherwise I'll be here all night trying to perhaps get them back to where they were and what have you. But yeah, I've got different settings and stuff and what have you. And you can obviously play either black or white, whichever you prefer. Obviously whites always have the advantage in chess of going first. Don't know why that is, but that's just the way it is for whatever reason. Whoever originally invented this game, nobody really knows. So yeah, okay. And like I said, there's different levels. You can play at different levels. You know, you can go right up to sort of like, I don't know. Well, I'm not 100% certain now because it's been a while since I checked out all the settings. But I think you can go pretty high level with it, I think. So I mean, I don't know if you can go like grandmaster or anything like that, but you can certainly go quite difficult levels on it. As I say, I've got it on the easiest setting of all because I don't want to tax my brain too much. So okay, let's have a little go and see how I get on, shall we? So let's just find the perfect on as you know closest you can get to, so I can hopefully you guys can see it and I can see. Right. Okay, so white has the advantage, like it says, so let's have a look. So basically, you just click on one of the pieces, you'll see that the squares light up and it shows, and that's the beauty of it as well. For somebody that's never played chess even, you know, because the thing is, look, watch, if I click on the knight, for instance, it shows you where you actually move to. So it'll show you the moves that the piece is allowed to do and the direction in which it's going to go and so on. So it's a really nice little game actually. It's really intuitive, really simple and easy. I really like it. And I like the graphics as well. The graphics are quite nice as well actually as it goes. So right, okay. So let's see, what's my opening gambit going to be? Let's see. We'll see. Right, okay. Right. There we go. So obviously you're playing the AI. You know, the computer you're playing a, and you know, obviously, it will do moves corresponding to whatever you do, sort of thing. So, okay, let's have a look where we're going. Now, of course, this might get a bit boring as a video, I can imagine, because there's not a lot of action, and sometimes I have to really think about the moves I'm making. And so there won't be necessarily a lot of commentary coming from me because I say obviously, but it's obvious to me that I'll want to be concentrating on what I'm doing. Like now, for instance. I'm not sure. Okay. Opening there. All right. Okay. All right. Let's move the knight. Let's go for it. Oh, wow, he's brought the queen out already. No way. What? Wow. Okay. Not sure I like that move. What are you up to? Okay. What are you doing? Wait. What am I doing? What am I doing? Never mind. What is he doing? I'll say he or it, whatever. What the heck am I doing? You see, this is what I'm saying about the thing is that with chess, it's the I don't think you see that many video games out there or videos made, YouTube videos where people have made a video. I like to say I've done a I think I've done one, maybe no, or I've done at least one. And what I did was I just speeded the thing up, and then I just put some fancy little edits in there just to make it look a little bit more interesting with a piece of music. I'm not sure if I'll do that with this one because obviously I'm talking a lot in this one, unlike the other one. Yeah, so I can imagine that this could become quite boring as a video, but I'm gonna put it up and we'll see how it gets on, and also the length of the thing as well. I've got to think about how long this video is gonna be ultimately, just in terms of editing, never mind just how long it's gonna and boring for you guys to watch. Right, okay, so what should I do? Oh, this is not a good idea. Wait. God, I've just realized he's gonna. Damn. I didn't really want to have to move my knight just yet, but trying to work out which is best. Okay, let's go back there for now. this is not looking good, man. I'm giving him all the advantages here. I've lost the advantage of moving first, just by because I've not got any clear plan. I don't know exactly what I'm doing. That's the thing with me in chess, is I love a good game of chess. I'm not very good at it. I'm not like brilliant. I don't got like really good strategies on how to play and all that lot. And I certainly can't think more than one or two moves ahead. You know what I mean? That's the best I can do, is about maybe one move ahead. Sometimes maybe two, but it just depends. And not all the time. I'm not overly confident when it comes to playing chess, but the thing is that because of that, I'm giving it, that is quite a strong setup there by the look of it, really, to me. That's starting to look like an impenetrable wall. Oh dear. Wait a minute, let me think. I haven't got a clue what I'm doing now. Come on. Well, why even bother? Okay. Interesting. Wait. Okay. Wait a minute. I haven't got a clue. Fine. Can't do that either, right? Okay. Right. Yeah. I know what you're going to do with that pawn, I swear. Right. So you've got to, I mean, he's going to take the pawn with the knight. He's going to take, I was thinking of putting my pawn there, threatening the queen. He's going to move his queen. There's no way he'll leave the queen there to be taken. I put the pawn there. His knight then takes my pawn. Of course, then I've got two pawns to then take his knight. So what happens after that? Right. See, the thing is with this, like I said, I mean, sometimes I can play a game and I can just get on with it and I can do it, you know, and it'll go quickly. And then other times, it'll be really slow. And I'm starting to wonder whether this is going to be worth doing as a video, because this will be extremely boring for you guys. I know it will. Alright. I'll play a little bit longer, but... Alright, okay. So if I move that pawn there, his knight is going to take that pawn. He might not even bother moving the queen. He'll just take it with the knight. I don't think that's my best move. I'm sure there's something better I could do, but I just can't see it at the moment. I'm sure there is a better move. Right, I might as well go for it. So let's see if I'm right. He's going to take this pawn with his knight. Oh! No way! What is he doing? What, he thinks it's queen safe just because the knight's covering the queen? But it's a pawn. You know, I mean, don't get me wrong, pawns, every piece on the chessboard. This is my personal opinions. Obviously, there's far better experts and grandmasters and world masters of chess out there that know the flipping ins and outs of a flipping what's name on these things. Do you know what I mean? I'm trying to think of a, that's why I'm saying what's name, because I can't think of someone. And, but, you know, every piece on the board is just as equally important. Well, maybe not equally as important, but can be just as important at times in various different situations. The pawns, not, you know, can be just as powerful if used in the right way. But the thing is, I mean, it's well worth the sacrifice. It's well worth losing a pawn to take his queen. That's flummoxed me. That is completely flummoxed me. I am completely dumbfounded. I thought, I mean, I know it's on the low setting, but flippy there, come on. I mean, wow, your queen. I'm just going to take your queen. And yeah, you can take me with your flipping knight. It's worth it, mate. That is one of the best bargains of the century. What the heck? Right. Your queen's going, mate. Don't know why you didn't move it or take my piece. Take the pawn. Now it'll probably take the pawn with the knight. Let's see if it does. Wow, I can't believe it. Wow, okay. Bye, queen. It still didn't take the pawn. What? What? No way. What the heck? Flipping heck, what setting have I got this on? It's like kindergarten or something, or what? I mean, for flipping heck, what the heck? Whoa. I mean, I know I'm no expert at this game. I'm not. Don't get me wrong, I love playing chess. I do. I absolutely love the game. I absolutely love it. I really do. I haven't played it for a long, long, long time, either physically with a real board or this way. I've even got a real chess board knocking about somewhere in the house. I just not played it for yonks and yonks and yonks. But I do. I love chess. I think I love it just as a gate. You know, it just really stimulates my brain. Really, I love it. I love it. But like I say, I'm not very good at it. Do you know what I mean? It's like, but still, you know, and I guess part of the reason is because I don't play it a lot anyway. Do you know what I mean? Play it once every blue moon, like, you know what I mean? So for something that I really love, you think, well, why don't you play it more? I don't know. That's a good question. But Yeah, I mean, wow. That's sorry, that's just I can't believe it didn't move the queen. Or take the piece, take the pawn. Okay, all right. So my now I've definitely got the advantage now. And it's now about pressing that advantage home. Okay. So sorry. Right, okay, let me think. There's no point doing that, I'll just lose the knight. He's gonna use that knight at some point, he's got to, hasn't he? I mean, flipping heck. Okay. Right, fine. Okay. Gotta get this moving. Flipping heck. Right. You know, I've just realised some. Oh my bye. Wait. Oh. Ah, right. Oh, gold. Why didn't I do that before? How's that looking there, by the way? I can't really tell that. Never mind. Sorry. I hope you guys can see this board properly. Right. Okay. This doesn't make any sense what I'm doing. I don't know why I'm doing that, but right, fine. Oh no! Oh! Ah, oh, flippin' it, it's the pawn. But flippin' it took long enough. Wow. Maybe I should have moved. Oh, never mind. Go on. Oh crap, sorry. I mean, oh dear. I forgot about the bishop. Sometimes it's hard to see what the pieces are sometimes because it's kind of dark up there at the top there, and it's kind of, oh, am I just making excuses? No, actually I honestly did not notice that that was a bishop up there. I completely forgot the bishop was there. Oops, sorry. Messing about. Right, I got. Right, okay. Well, obviously, I'm not gonna let you just demolish all my. Right, so, well, you're definitely going. Oh, another knight, eh? Wow. Right, okay. Oh right, I see. Right. Well, I know what you're not going to move. Well, at least I think I do. Right, fine. Chances are he's going to take me with this one. Yep. That's what I thought you would do. Oh, for crying out loud. That's not actually what I intended. This is becoming a bit of a pain in the bum. That's not what I intended. Shoot. Right, fine. You sneaky, sneaky. Right, okay. I think that's what it's doing. It's lulling me into a false sense of flipping. What's it? Right, okay. Oh, that's your rook up there, isn't it? Oh, no. Oh, no. You're even covering the pawn with your flipping knight, and this time he will take it. I know he will. He's gonna bring the rook down as soon as I go for this. He's going to bring that rook down there. I might be wrong. Oh, I was wrong. But still a bit of a dodgy position to be in. Really. Oh, man. How am I going to... Wait. Come on, Paul. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Got a bit of a deadlock going up here with these up here. Right, so why did you do that? That don't make any sense either. Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? Unless it thinks I'm going to take the pawn. Why should I take the pawn? I could take the pawn. See, because that's black on black there, I can't see, and I'm pretty sure it is a bishop, but I do like this, actually. I love the fact that you can do all that. That's so cool. Right, hang on, sorry. Oh, no, I'm confusing myself now. What the heck am I doing? Right. Okay, oh, okay, okay, okay. Settle down, Paul. Settle down. Right. Oh, sorry. Right. Nope. Right. That's it. Right. Oh, for crying out loud. Oh, right. Okay. Oh, damn. Can't do that either. Oh, that would have been a brilliant little what's in. Wait. Oh, well, that's a little bit. Really, is that worth it? Wait. So if I offer up my bishop, I'm assuming he will take the bishop, but I don't know what this thing's going to do, to be quite honest. It seems to be unpredictable. I think I can predict its moves, but then it does something completely different. So if I sacrifice, it's not a good idea, but if I sacrifice my bishop, he takes my bishop, that gives me space to move my knight, put the king in check. But then where's the king go? Who's backing up the knight? But then, if he... Also, and I can take the rook. Oh, is that really worth it? Is all of that really worth it? I don't know. All right, hang on. Wait. I mean, my knight's pretty safe for another time being, at least. Okay, I'm going to just take this little pawn out for now. This seemed like a bit of a plan, but I'm not sure that it's going to work. So, okay. Okay. We still have the issue of the bishop. Yeah. Right, okay. And we got that knight there to contend with. Right, come on, think, Paul. Oh, do you know where I should have done that? Oh, shoot. Actually, he can't. No, he can't take my. What? Oh, yeah. The knight's fine. What? Wait. Oh, wait. What? Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Shoot. Okay. Wait a minute. So I should have taken that out. Why did I leave it? Never mind, it doesn't matter. Right. Oh, this is. Wait. Hang on. Wait. So, what if we. Yeah, but what's the point of that? Okay, right. I don't think this is a good idea, but I'm gonna go for it. See what happens. Ooh, tricky. Oh, he's after my rook, by the look of it. Oh, come on. Oh, wow. I guess that's one of the things about this as well, actually thinking about it. I think, although I guess a lot of chess games, and there must be, I don't know, literally thousands of them out there. Yeah, I don't know. I think I've got a funny feeling that with the AI on this, I don't know how it's programmed or whatever. I mean, I don't begin to pretend to understand anything about computer programming and algorithms and all the rest of it and this, that, and the other, and blah, blah, blah. But the way this thing plays, it feels very real. Like you're playing a real person as opposed to playing a machine that has standardized moves that it's aware of or whatever. You know, the way, I don't know, I'll say aware of, you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? It's like you're almost playing a real person and somebody who's also a novice. Or maybe not even. Kind of thing. I don't know. I don't know. It's just there's something about, because I mean, wow, this feels very much like a ton of other games that I've had with countless different people from all walks of life throughout my life at various different places and situations and what have you. I've had some really, really interesting games with people. By the way, you may be noticing every now and again there's a little black square that's popping up. Originally, when I first downloaded this game, they were adverts. You would get little adverts popping up on it every now and again. Now, I think that's probably what it is, those little black squares. But for whatever reason, the advert itself is no longer playing, but the little thing's still popping up. So I don't know if you was wondering what that those little black squares were. I don't know if you noticed them. I don't know if you pick it, if it's picking it up on there. I'm assuming it must be. Because you've got virtually the whole board in front of you there. Right, anyway, sorry. Sidetracking again. Yeah, so it plays very... quite intuitively, in a way. Because this feels very much like some games where sometimes I'll play with someone and we'll probably be about the same sort of level in terms of competency, in terms of playing chess. One might be slightly better than the other or whatever. I'm not sure. You know what I mean? It all varies. But sometimes you can play a game with somebody and you can beat them maybe 2-3 times on a row or whatever. And then sometimes you'll play a game with that same person and you for whatever reason, you both end up getting it. It gets really complex. Instead of it being a really quick game and, you know, I don't know if I'm explaining myself clearly or not. I know what I'm trying to say. It's just that, like, the times I've played this game before, I've beaten it quite quickly. And that's not to say that I'm, like, really good and I'm so such a genius that I can beat the AI. Because, like I say, it's always on the lowest setting anyway. You know, the easiest setting. It's just very rarely do I get bogged down like this when I've played this particular game, this particular one. I don't usually get bogged down like this. You know what I mean? It's all getting a bit... Look where they're all congregating in this corner here, and it's all getting a bit... Do you know what I mean? Wow, interesting. Right, sorry, I just like... what am I talking about? Right, oh, yeah. Ah, right. Oh, wait a minute. Right. See, doing all that chit-chatting, I completely forgot what I was doing. Yeah, he's after my rook, isn't he? And I've just remembered that my bishop is also vulnerable because I did that thinking that I was going to lose the bishop anyway. And I had another little strategy in mind, and now that's gone completely out of my head because I've been chatting. Oh, come on, Paul. Oh, I don't want to lose either of those pieces if I can help it. But I've got a funny feeling as soon as I try to move one and save one, I'm going to lose the other. So I'm either going to lose the bishop, I'm either going to lose this bishop, or I'm going to lose this rook. Sorry, I don't know if you can see where I'm pointing to, by the way, with the cursor. Can you see that cursor or not? Sorry, I have no idea until I play this back what you guys will be able to see or not. Sorry. Yeah, so either... That is going to go, or that is going to go. So whichever one I try to save, I think I'm not going to be able to save both. But as I said just a minute ago, this game is fairly unpredictable, so I think I know why he moved off that back row and all. Maybe. Come on, come on. What am I going to do? No. Go there, he's gonna do that. Wait. What about you gonna take it? Right. Oh man, I'm not sure. Right. Oh, he's gonna this is really annoying. I think I'm going to save the rook. Just trying to think. What? Right. Save the rook. Oh, you see, it didn't do what I thought it was going to do. Alright, so now you're gunning for my queen. Okay. Now that is definite. He's definitely going to go for my queen. That pawn has now become a liability. This one here, sorry. This one. This is now a liability to me. I should have moved that thing with my rook in the first place. I just wanted to get my rook up here somewhere. I was trying to get, well, I wasn't, like I say, strategies, I don't necessarily, I've got rough strategies, but they're not always, but I was definitely thinking I should have got rid of that first, but I was leaving it there because at the time it seemed pretty innocuous and harmless, you know what I mean? It's like, but now obviously it's presenting a bit of an issue because I was thinking of protecting the queen with the bishop. That would mean that it would deter him from trying to take the queen, because I'd just then take, you know, because if he took the bishop, obviously I'd just take him. But then the pawn, and I can't, and then that also threatens my king, which means I have to move the king. And in the meantime, hang on, wait. And of course, the way he's got his king positioned, I can't easily get a check on him. Damn, come on. Wow, I must admit, like I said, I've never been in a game with this computer before, with this AI, this particular AI, and got this bogged down like this before. Wow. Well, I say, I've played it a few times, and I'm not, as I say, I'm not blowing my own trumpet, because I'm not a very good chess player at all. I really love the game, I really enjoy it, but like I said, because I've got it on the lowest setting, more often than not, I play this game with it, and you know, it usually goes fairly quickly. Not always. There have been occasions when it's got bogged down like this, but not that regular. More often than not, like I say, I can play it right the way through, and it usually goes fairly quickly, and I usually do fairly well. I usually win. Not always. Again, like I say, sometimes I have lost to it, even on this setting. But man, wow, oh man, I don't know what to do. Oh my god, obviously I need to protect my queen. I can't take his piece. I could just try moving the queen. I guess that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to save the queen. Oh! Oh, wow. Oh, man. You tricky dicky. Right, okay, right. Shit, of course the queen. Oh, shit, do you know, I've just only just realised what I just did and all. Luckily, it didn't go for my queen with the other rook. Oh, this is getting... What the heck is going on, man? Now the queen's completely vulnerable, and I need to get her out of the way again. And now I've lost the advantage, and now I'm going to lose the flipping rook for definite this time, and he's going to put my king in check. Oh, for crying out loud. Great. So great. Oh, brilliant. All right then. Fine. Oh no, I can't even move the queen back either, can I? Oh no, what have I done? What the heck have I done? Oh man, I'm seriously screwing this game up. Right, get rid of them. Ooh, eh? Now you see what I mean about this computer or this AI. It has just done the most ridiculous move. That even a complete novice, I think, well, maybe a complete novice might do that move. Maybe, I don't know, but I mean, flipping heck. What was the point of that? You didn't even take anything. I mean, I would get that move if it took even a pawn. I would get that move. Not necessarily I think it would be worth doing that, but I would get it. But just to move the rook down there, just because I put my queen there. It's got no backup. There's nothing to back it up. And take it with my bishop or my queen now. In fact, I'm probably better off taking it with the queen, actually. You see, it keeps doing perplexing moves, and I'm like, what? Why the hell has it done that? It's not gained anything. Well, of course, you could argue that my next move, it's definitely going to take the rook. It's going to take this. So, bishop, sorry, knight takes my rook. Well, sorry, let's do the sequence. So I take that rook with my queen, and his next move is to take the knight, sorry, to take my rook. So we both lose a rook. But again, with this flipping, what's that? I have no idea. Let's see what happens. That's my prediction. Let's see if my prediction's right. So I'm going to take his rook, and then he should then take my rook with his knight. Let's see what happens, shall we? Yeah, finally, my prediction, and of course, he's put me in check. Which I completely forgot he would do, actually. I should have thought that one through a little bit longer, never mind, doesn't matter, it's not too bad. Of course, he's going to move him, but where's he going to take that knight? Oh, hey, you see, that's a, again, why didn't he move the knight? In the process, it could have taken one of my pawns. And no damage to itself whatsoever. And it gains one of my pieces. And yet it didn't do that. Wow. I might have to up the level on this because that didn't make any. None of this is making any sense. I mean, I know I've got it on the easy level, but for crying out loud. I don't. See, I'm sorry, it's just really perplexing me. I've definitely played it on this level before, but I don't remember it making. I mean, yes, sometimes it's made a bit of the odd sort of move that's made me go, what? Do you know what I mean? But not like this. This doesn't make any sense. Why would you? All I've got to do is just take your bishop now. Dead easy. I mean, your knight. Sorry, I beg your pardon. I am well confused. Right, take it. You see, all it did was move its king backwards and forwards from those two squares. What? It can't take this, can't take my knight, because it'll put itself in check with my two pawns. And you can't do that. You can't put yourself in check. Right, fine. Okay. You see, you got this bishop here as well, which could have easily taken this other bishop at any point, but it didn't. It's just been sat there. Right, what is that? A Yeah, that's a pawn, isn't it? Right. Right, okay. Another prediction. I want to get rid of this bishop, but I don't want to lose my bishop over it. I can't see at the moment at least, any other way. Because I could take the bishop, but then his pawn is definitely going to take my bishop. At least, again, that's I'm assuming it will. So if I force his hand by... But then he's got this little pawn that he can deal with that with. Right, hang on. Let me see. How am I going to get round this? Okay, let's see, let's see, let's see, let's see. Right, fine. So what if... Right, let me try some... Okay. So... Okay. That's fine. Okay. Right. Although I don't right. I'm gonna Sorry. Just trying to get a nice so I can see what I'm doing properly. I've kind of got things blocked in a bit here. Alright, let's get him over here. Yeah, you're fine. I don't care where you're going at the moment. You can't do anything in a minute. Right, okay. Right, so let's get you there. Oh, okay. That's rather annoying. Oh, oh, got my knight to take care of you, but then I lose my knight, which I'm not that happy about. Oh, that's really annoying. I was just thinking, I'm onto someone here, and then now I've got to stop my concentration on that and now concentrate on how do I best deal with this situation. I just moved the king, I know, but okay. Oh man, okay, fine. Now it's after my okay. What? Okay, if that's the way you're gonna play it, fine. Got you now, haven't I? I've just realised. Yep. I thought there was at least maybe another move or two before I was going to get there. But actually, it's just done its job for me because I got one move. Now, for those of you who don't know or don't play chess or whatever, I don't know how many of my subscribers do or don't know what my next move is going to be or can see what my next move is going to be. But one move, checkmate, I've got him. Put himself right in that corner, and that's it. He's done because my queen. Oh wait! I'm jumping the gun. I keep forgetting. Oh, that pawn. Of course. Now I've got to eat all of my words. Take everything back I've just said. That would have been checkmate, but I forgot about the pawn. Because the pawn will block. You can still, yeah, you can still get out of that corner. You still can get out. You can still get out the corner. And there wouldn't be much point in me doing this move then. I was going to put my rook over in this corner. If that pawn there hadn't have been there, that would have been it. That would have been checkmate. Damn, that blinking pawn. Oi, you. Yes, you there. What are you doing there? You just stopped me from slaughtering your king, capturing your king. I look at that. I look at that. It's pretty cool. Look, you can even see the reflections, and I swear those reflections, do they move? It looks like they move. Look, the reflection changes. Oh wow, that is so cool. The reflection on the piece. If you look at this reflection, this highlighted, as I move it, that the reflection definitely changes. Like it would in real life if he was moving a real. Oh, how cool is that? Look, the reflections move. That is. I never even noticed that before. Wow. That is really wicked. Look at that. Look at the reflections. The reflections move. That's actually a window. That's a reflection of a window. Wow, that is really awesome. I never noticed that until just now. I've never really had it this up close before. I've never done the full screen, I don't think, properly. But the reflections move. Wow, that's some good graphics. If it's oh wow, that is pretty awesome, man. Wow. Oh wow, I never noticed that before. Sorry, folks. Oh God, I've lost. I've completely disorientated myself. Where the hell? All right, yeah. Oh God, that was a bit. Right. Okay. So for that little Mr. Pawn in the way, that's really. Okay. Sorry. Just gonna try and get a nice, comfortable angle that feels kind of right. Kind of. Anyway. Right. Stop fussing about that for a minute. Wait. Oh, come on. I don't know. Oh man. Oh wait a minute. Means I lose my knight though. Oh, it might be. Oh, is it going to be worth it? Maybe. I'll lose my knight over this, but at least I get rid of his bishop. Oh wait, no. That's really dangerous, actually. I just realized. That gives him an opportunity in opening to get one of his pawns onto my back. Because again, I don't know if you guys are aware, but if he gets, or if I get one of my pawns onto this back space, if I've lost my queen or he's lost his queen, or it doesn't even matter whether you lost your queen or not, if you've lost a significant piece, whether it's the queen, bishop, knight, or rook, you can request one of those pieces back if you get a pawn onto my back row. So if he gets a black pawn onto the white pieces back row, and the same vice versa. So I was going to take his bishop out because it was. So I mean, I need to get something moving so I can get rid of this thing. And but like I say, if I do that, then he takes me with his pawn, and then he's got a clear run all the way to the back. So that wouldn't be good. Great. Oh, hey, no, oh, hey. Stop it. Right, okay. Damn. Right. Okay, so the only move I can think Oh, wait a minute. Oh my God. I've been waffling on all this time and I didn't even see the alternative move that actually. Let me just double check this a minute. Yeah. You see, you guys might have seen this before. I might be thinking, excuse me, Paul, hello, it's that one. Yeah, right. So, after all that, I double take back everything I've just said. Oh, for crying out loud, this is so. I feel such an idiot. Right, okay, fine. So, basically. The move that I actually need to make, and we'll do it in one move, and it will be checkmate, and I don't have to worry about anything else, is to take the pawn with the queen. Staring me in the face, and I can't see it. You know what I mean? It's like, I'm thinking, like, oh, get the rook on the back, what's him, and then we've got him. Because as soon as I take that, that is over for the black pieces. It's done. Because, like I said, as far as I can see, as soon as I take that, he can't move there, he can't move there, he can't move there, it's checkmate. Oh man, that took me long enough. And nothing can touch my queen. Completely safe. There's another. Right, I'm going for it. Oh, what an. I am. What am I like? Right, now we've got checkmate. I was just thinking about the wrong move to get checkmate. Took me long enough. Hey, what? Whoa, what? Oh, of course, he's not. Oh, you see? For some reason, this game is just. I've never had a game like this where I'm just completely. Oh, great. Oh, for crying out loud. You see, now. Right, fine. Fine. Oh, shit, I can't move the queen, king there. He'll have to go there then, won't he? All right, fine. What? This. Right now it should be checkmate. Oh. Pulling the air out. Right. Okay. Now it's got to be checkmate. What's going on? Right. You definitely can't go there. There. You can't move twice to get out of check. You can only move once. So you can only move one square at a time. The king can only move one square at a time. So he and he can't. You can't put yourself deliberately into check. So he can't move to this white square. He can't move to that square. And as soon as I put my rook on that box, then it's definitely checkmate. And he can't move to that square either. That's why initially I'm thinking I've got checkmate with that one move. But then I missed something. And now I can't even remember what the heck I missed. Right. Watch. Definitely checkmate now. Freaking heck! Wow, that took long enough. Right, talking of long enough, I think this video has gone on way too long. I have no idea how well this video is going to do, so I'm just going to leave it there for now. I'm going to edit this and I shall catch you guys later. Bye for now.